Welcome students. In today's lecture, from the point testing of hypothesis, we are going to concentrate chi-square test. But before that, just few points we have to remind that where we are using the chi-square test. When there is a qualitative data, and most of the times in breeding and genetical experiment is qualitative data, so we are using their chi-square test. Okay, in breeding experiment we have to select ratio which is suitable for observed value, but what we are exactly getting, there is a deviation and variation. Remember, there is a deviation and variation between observed and expected value, and this is high. So by using the chi-square test, we can find out whether these deviations are significant or not, or that fits good to that data or not. That's why this test is also known as the goodness of fit test, and our main objective is either observed data agree with the expected one. Okay, now how this agreement we can conclude? So let's go for the formula and then we will solve one or two examples. So here the formula is chi square. This is denoted by the letter chi, and this is nothing but the x. So here summation of O, that is observed frequency, and E, that is expected frequency. Okay, and this is its square and it is divided by expected frequency. Very simple formula is there, and from that if we will get a specific value, if the calculated value is less than tabular value, difference are considered are significantly smaller and it fits good. And if it is opposite, that if value is greater than the tabular value, then fit is not good. Remember, calculated value, suppose this is calculated value, it is less than tabular value, then it fits good. And if calculated value is greater than tabular value, then it does not fit. Okay, or fit is not good. So you can concentrate on this calculated and tabular value. So if, as I told you in t-test also, if any significance level is not given, we have to use the 5%. So there are generally 5% and 10% level of significance are used. Let's go for the example for the 3:1 ratio of the Mendel's experiment. So what he has observed here, but before that the hypothesis, null hypothesis. Okay, null hypothesis is, it is presumed that tall and dwarf plants are segregating in 3:1 ratio. It means after doing field experiment we will get exactly 3:1, that is 600 observed and expected. What we are expecting when we give its 3:1 ratio, the 606 and 202 plant we have to get, but we are getting these values. Okay, so just this is your null hypothesis, that they are segregating in 3:1 ratio. So here expected number is 606 for tall plants. How it is calculated? 3 divided by 4 means out of 4, 3 plants are 3% plants are tall, and total plants are your 808. Like that, here 606 are tall plant and 202 plants are dwarf plant. Just put these values in your table, that we need observed frequency and expected frequency. So tall plants, they are 621 observed, and dwarf plant 187. But expected value is 606 for the tall plant and 202 for the dwarf plant. No doubt total is 808. So they are deviating from the expected value. We need 606 plant, but we are getting 621. So by subtracting, we will get the deviation. And here also we will get the deviation for the dwarf plants also. Just put this value in formula, where summation of observed frequencies, expected frequencies, its square divided by expected frequencies. So here for the tall plant and for the dwarf plant. So by doing the calculation, we will get the chi-square value is 1.4852. Just put the values from this table, observed frequencies. Where it is observed frequency? Here, or sorry, here, deviation, F, that is a frequency deviation. So we have to use 15 square here also for the dwarf plant, that is a minus 15 square, and divided by expected frequency for tall and expected frequency for dwarf. So we'll get the chi square value, and that is 1.4852, and tabular value is 3.84 at 5% level of probability of 1 degree of freedom. Now 1 degree of freedom, how it comes? We have two observations, tall and dwarf, and degree of freedom is nothing but the n minus 1. 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So for degree of freedom 1, the value from the table is at 5% level is 3.84. Since there is 1 degree of freedom, value is, tabular value is 3.84. Now remember what I have told you, that if calculated value, just I am going back to slide here, calculated value, if it is less than tabular value, then it fits good, and if it is less, it does not fits. Okay, so what we have observed, calculated value is how much? Your 1.48, and your tabular value is 3.84. So it is smaller, sorry, it is smaller than your tabular value. Okay, and thus there is difference between the observed and expected frequency is not significant. And that's why the null hypothesis is true. What is our null hypothesis? That they are observing in 3:1 ratio. So the results of two groups of plants are in agreement with the your theoretical ratio. Okay. So this example is for monohybrid cross. Similarly, for the dihybrid cross, here they have given the plants are expected to occur as per the dihybrid ratio 9:2, 3:2, 3:1, and this ratio, the observed frequency is like 891, 316, 290 and 119 for specific traits, that is round yellow, wrinkled yellow, round green and the wrinkled green. What they have asked, find out the chi-square value, examine the correspondence between theory and the experiment. Again we have to put any hypothesis. So here we have put the null hypothesis, theoretical value corresponds to the experimental value, I mean we are expecting that one. So as per the data, total number of plants are how much? Just do the sum of all the observed plant, and that will get 1616. From this we have to calculate the each trait value. How this is calculated? First trait is round and yellow. Total is 16, 9:2, 9 + 3 + 3 + 1, 9 + 3 = 12, 12 + 3 = 15 + 1 = 16. So round yellow plants are 9 divided by 16, and they are out of 1616. So we'll get 909 round yellow plant. Same like here for the wrinkled yellow, 3 divided by 16 into 1616. So again you will get this value, Similarly, for round green, same calculation, 303, and wrinkled gain only 1 out of 16. So here 101. Next to this, just put this value in observed and expected. Observed frequency, what is there? So these four values are there, okay? And expected, we have calculated in the last slide. So 909, okay? So expected frequency we will get like this. Just put this value again in this table, and like this monohybrid ratio, calculate the deviation by subtracting the observed and expected frequency. No doubt again total is the same. Just put this value, but here the four values we have to put as per the 9:3:2, 3:3:1 ratio. So just square this frequency and you will get these values by adding all these values. We will get the chi-square 4.67, and the tabulated x value is 7.8 for 3 degree of freedom. Again, we are with the 4 threads. So degree of freedom is 4 minus 1, and that is equal to 3. Okay. So this shows that chi-square value is less than the tabulated value, means your calculated value is less than 4.6. It is less than your tabular value. Okay, tabular value is 7.80. So from this, difference between the observed and expected frequencies is not significant. So null hypothesis that stating the observed and expected frequencies have no difference, and this can be expected. So this is about the dihybrid ratio, how we can use for the chi-square test. Again, this is the table, right, same as that of a t-test, where degree of freedom in this column and horizontal there are the significance level. So by using a specific your degree of freedom, you will get significance level values, and we can finalize our decision by comparing the calculated and the tabular values. This is all about the chi-square test, which we have used for monohybrid and the dihybrid cross examples. Thank you.